Hi, Faye. This week's tip is financial enlightenment, understanding the numbers. Now, before you all glaze over or nod off, it's not that scary. Suffice to say, we can have pages and pages of numbers, we can have maths and sums and all that sort of stuff, and for the most part, people will just tune out. But let's make that a whole heap more simpler and more useful. Very simply, for every dollar that you don't spend, you've got one more dollar in your pocket. But there's no leverage from that. So when we run a business, often people think to get a bigger profit, they need to spend less on things that they might otherwise need. So you become restrictive. Sure, you might look at your insurance or your rental or your phone packages and those sorts of things, and certainly pare back the areas that might be overspent. Certainly things like advertising are often very inefficient, and there's areas like that. But once you've done your homework on all the obvious things, look at where you can get leverage from the dollars that you do spend. And that comes from being aware of what things need to be spent to give leverage in the income. And often that is by just adding one more person a week or one more upsell to every customer that comes in. Obviously, McDonald's does this really well. Just, do you want to upsize? Do you want fries with that? But things like hairdressing, for example, might sell a bottle of shampoo, and they might schedule the people to come once more in that year. Just those tiny little tweaks can make an exponential difference to the top line, and then the other expenses, you don't have to cull back and cut out things like, you know, electricity, or cut back the phone. You know, I won't ring my mother on Wednesdays, and all those sorts of things that I hear people say, because you're actually cutting back to a point where your business can't run properly. So it's a little bit hard without writing it in front of us, but just work out where you do get leverage from the dollars spent, and work with an accountant or another financial advisor to say which are the effective dollars and which are not.
Thank you, Dianna.
Thanks, Faye.